Hey everyone, welcome to another great episode of the Smooth Business Growth Podcast, where we share 15 minutes of fast-paced pure marketing strategies proven to move the needle in your business. So I'm your host and captain, Lindsay Phillips. I'm the founder of Smooth Sailing Business Growth, where we help busy entrepreneurs attract and acquire customers faster through powerful and consistent content marketing. In fact, if you go to smoothbusinessgrowth.com, you can download your social media roadmap to help you do just that. Now, I was saying off air a couple minutes ago that everything happens for a reason. And I am super excited to be speaking today with author, speaker, book coach, Dan Janal, who's going to share the essential steps to start writing your first book. He's actually the author of Write Your Book in a Flash. And I know everyone that knows me out there knows I've been writing my darn book forever and I need to get going on it. So this is perfect timing. So let's set sail. Welcome aboard, Dan.
Aye, aye, Captain. Thanks for having me on your ship, on your boat, on your yacht, whatever.
Yes. Ooh, glad yacht. To be aboard. Yes, I'd like to envision the yacht personally. Perfect. And now let's just kind of get this out of the way here. Why are books so important for entrepreneurs? Why do we need to have a book?
That's a great place to start. You know, books set you apart from everyone else. You know, let's face it, everyone has competition. You have competition. I have competition. And if people look at our resumes and our backgrounds, you know, we've all gone to good schools. We've all done wonderful things. We all have great clients. We all have wonderful testimonials. We all have lots of followers on Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn and all that good stuff. So what separates us from someone else? It very well might be that you're the person who wrote a book. And frankly, if you've written a book, you are then seen as an expert. You are branded in a totally different way than everyone else in your market. And furthermore, the book stands as a silent salesperson. No one ever throws away.
I like that phrase.
Thank you. I didn't invent it though. The book sit, no one throws a book away. They put the book on the bookcase and it stands out and your face is on the spine. Your name is on the spine. The title of the book is on the spine. It's staring out at them 24/7 every day until they finally wake up and say, I need someone who can do whatever. And wasn't there that someone person where she had a sailboat show or something? And I think I have her name. Let me look on my bookcase and bingo, there it is. And then they hire you. The book gets people to know, like, and trust you.
Awesome. And absolutely. It's just that whole credibility is huge. And to me, it's like for a lot of people too, I think it gets their foot in the door to get on podcast shows and just increase exposure. I mean, there's so many good reasons.
Sure. It really is the gift that keeps on giving, but you have to write the book, and that's what holds up a lot of people. Yeah. And, you know, frankly, you might have the makings of a book and not even realize it. And what I mean by that is that there are a couple of different levels of books. And I talk about that in my book as well. There are people who've just written books that just have quotes, you know, 100 pages
that's
of quotes,
true.
Two quotes per page, little lines for writing and taking notes. And, you know, that's okay. If that's what's going to set you apart, if that's what's going to inspire people, that's perfectly fine for some people. Other people might have written blog posts for a year or two or three. So they have 50 or 100. 100 or 150 articles already written. You can take those blog posts and maybe re-edit them or maybe just put them into a book. And now you have a nice size book that shows your thinking so people get to know, like, and trust you. Of course, you can go a little bit higher up the scale. You know, there are different kinds of books and different levels of books, but you don't have to write the good to great book, you know, the In Search of Excellence, you know, the number one bestseller business book. That's not what this is about.
Right.
We're talking about books that are big business cards, books that show your expertise, books that show that you are the person that they need to hire to coach them, to show that you are the guide that can lead them through this horrible mess they're in and lead them to the promised land that solves their problems. That's what the book is all about. So look through your blog posts, look through your transcripts. You know, if you've been on podcasts, if you've done speeches, get the transcripts of those speeches and those podcasts and turn those into chapters in your book. So it might be a lot easier to write your book than you think.
That's true. Because I know for me personally, it's like I have this preconceived idea of what it's supposed to look like. And I think, and I'm sure there's many other entrepreneurs out there that think the same thing, that they get hung up on that.
Yeah, and there really is no reason to do that, because people read books or buy books for one reason. They want to solve a problem.
Right, right.
If your book title says 62 ways to fill in the blank, you know, get famous on social media, mow your lawn, fix your garage door, get more clients and real estate bookings, whatever. That's what people are going to be gravitated for. And they don't necessarily read the book from front to cover. They look to find the answer to their problems. In fact, books today are thinner and thinner than ever before. I was at a conference, and the keynote speaker was a customer support person, and a great speaker. I mean, he gets paid thousands and thousands of dollars to speak and gets consulting from the best companies in America. And he gave away copies of his book. And I was surprised by it, because it was a really thin book. It was maybe 64 pages. And during the Q&A, I said, you know, thanks for giving us your book, but, you know, it's kind of thin. I mean, there's a lot of good information here. There are a lot of good stories here. There's a lot of good advice here, a lot of short tips and information. But is this the future of publishing? And he said, it sure is, because he wrote that book for the frontline service personnel in retail stores. Do you think they want to read a PhD level book about customer service and read footnotes and graphs and charts and whatever?
So
no, they want nice, light, inspiring stories. And that's exactly what he wrote. So look at the what your intention is. What do you want to get done? What do you want the book to do for you? And then write the book that meets that purpose. And it could be 64 pages. It could be 128 pages. It could be 200 pages. But frankly, it shouldn't be any more than that, because people look at a book that's more than 200 pages and say, that's off-putting. I don't have time to read it. I'll make the time sometime. And that'll never happen. So you want a book that is accessible to people.
Well, you've just made my shoulders drop. And I'm sure other people feel the same way out there. Now, before we even start, you know, writing our first word, our first paragraph, our first chapter, what do we need to be clear on? What do we need to kind of, do we need to get in the right mindset? What's the first step?
The first step is really to write the outline. And actually, before you write the outline, write the back cover copy of the book. You know, basically 200 words here. This isn't a big exercise, but if you can do this, then you can write your book. There are four questions. It's like, who will benefit from reading this book?
Yeah.
And how will they benefit? What is their key takeaway? How are they going to be a better person or a better business person because they've read the book? You know. And then third, why are you the right person to write this book? And fourth, what other, you know, key differentiations make this book different from other books on the market? If you can answer those questions, you can begin to start writing the book. And you'll use that exercise on the back cover of your book and also on your Amazon description for the book.
Right.
So this has a lot of value here. It also gets you focused, because now you're in the mindset of who you're actually writing this book for and how they will actually benefit for it. And you're pumping yourself up, because you said, I'm the right person to write this book because of my experience in doing this stuff and whatever. And then, you know, you're going with a positive frame of mind. At that point, I want you to write an outline. I want you to think of the 10 chapters. The first chapter tells them what you're going to tell them. The last chapter is the conclusion. That tells them what you've told them and also how they can work with you, because they can't implement all the steps in the book without you. Well, maybe some people can, but the higher level people, the one you really want to work with, they're the ones who are going to say, how can I take the next step and work with you?
Right.
And that's where you explain how they can take the next their next step. You know, that's your call to action. The other 8 chapters show them their problems and how you've helped other companies solve those problems. If you can do that in 128 pages or 20 to 25,000 words, you have a book. And again, you might have that material already written in your blog posts and your transcripts and your podcasts.
Sweet. Now, we were talking off air before we hit record, and I was just saying, you know, one of the things that I'm stuck on, and I'm being totally honest with people out here, is that I get stuck on the part where you have to share stories. My memory sucks for like what happened in the past, not gonna lie. For like, you know, people even ask me, you know, when did you start your business? Oh, I don't remember. It was like 5 years ago. And it's like, so how, that's where I'm stuck. I'm like, I don't know how to interject those stories, because I feel like I can't just pull them out of my head.
Fantastic. And I'm glad you asked that question during the pre-interview, and I purposely didn't answer it so you could do it live online so I can get your reaction. Okay, this is cool. Okay, I had a client who had the exact same reaction. He had written a wonderful book about communication skills in the workplace and how to talk to people and blah, 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 get through difficult situations, blah, blah, blah. It was all very nice, all very technical, whatever. It needed stories. And frankly, every book needs stories.
Yeah.
Why? Because people are hardwired to remember stories. They don't remember anything else, but they'll remember the story. So if you want people to remember your how-to and your advice and your morals, whatever, you have to wrap it in a story. You have to introduce it with a story. So here's the exercise that I used with him, because, you know, he's my book coach, or I was his book coach, he was my coach E. He said, I can't write stories. And I said, well, I know you can't write stories, but if you could... That's an NLP tactic, by the way.
Yes.
I take that from Tony Robbins. I know you can't do this, but if you could you think of a time when you actually helped one of your employees do a better job because you gave her some coaching advice? And he said, well, there is this time, and I swear this is a true story. I can tell it. He published it. He gave me permission to do it. He was the director of PR for Scholastic Publishing, which had the assignment of publishing this new series of books by this writer from England who no one had ever heard of called JK Rowling, who had a series of books called Harry Potter. And he was in charge of the market, the PR for it. And he assigned one of his underlings to basically go around with J.R. Rowling on all of her press tours and help her out. And now they are best friends, this woman and the author. And, you know, all because he trained her to work with this. And he told the story about how the woman said, you know, I really am not confident, whatever. And he coached her through her confidence and her issues and whatever, and helped her get to the next level. And obviously she's in a totally different level because of that now. All because he reached out and mentored her. And that story was so great, it became the lead story in the book.
Totally.
So it really wasn't that hard to do. Once you get through your negative self-talk and say, well, I can't write stories and I don't know this. And everyone tells stories whether they know it or not. You know, it's part of human nature. So all you have to do is sit down in front of your reporter and start talking.
Yeah.
Or sit down in front of your computer and start typing, because we all have different modalities. Do whatever works for you. There's no right, there's no wrong. If it works, then it's the right modality for you. So maybe just sitting down in front of a computer was a little bit daunting, but if you talk about it and pretend you're talking to your best friend about a great time or a time when you helped someone or one of your clients, one of your coaching clients do something, that might be good enough. That may be all you need. In fact, it may be better than good enough. It may be absolutely perfect. And you're just defeating yourself by doing negative self-talk, which is, of course, useless.
That's true. And I think what resonated with me was having people ask you questions so that it feel like even if you have someone or, you know, book coach or coach or whoever that's going through your book, ask you a question and then it just feels like a natural conversation versus, oh my God, I have to write this story. It has to sound right. And then if you just speak it and talk it and share the story, you're done.
Exactly. And you might find yourself looking at a story and saying, what's the point of this story? And you you come up with a moral, which is great. And you might find that if you ask yourself, what is another point in this story, you come up with another moral. In fact, I was at a workshop, and the speaker called on a person at random and said, you know, tell me a story. And the guy told a story about his grandmother and cookies. And the speaker said, what's the moral of the story? And the guy said, I don't know. I don't think there's a moral to the story at all. You know, my grandmother made cookies, you know, that was it. And he opened up the floor to people in the audience and said, what's the moral of the story? And 10 people gave 10 different answers. Your grandmother showed she loved you by baking the cookies, or you always associate the smell of cookies with your grandmother and home and family and good things. And, you know, 10 different people, again, 10 different answers.
Yeah.
And and they all made sense. So you just may write the story and then show it to some of your friends or your mastermind group friends or your beta readers and say, what do you think of the story? What's the purpose of the story? Let them come up with the answer.
Cool.
And you might find you have a customer service story. You might find you have a gratitude story. You might find you have, you know, any number of different stories there. Sometimes we need help, and that's where a good coach comes in. That's where a good developmental editor comes in.
Yeah.
They can see things that you can't see.
Yeah, that's true. Sometimes you can't see the forest for the trees. We have just a couple of minutes left, but I do want to ask, because I've never heard this term before, what is a book coach and how can they help? Because I know this is what you do.
Sure. A book coach, just like a coach for basketball or anything else, you know, they help you get through the dip. You know, we all want to write a book and then we're all excited about writing a book. And then we enter this dip like, oh my God, I have to write the book.
I know. Like,
I don't know where this is going. I don't know where the stories are. I'm lost. That's where a book coach or developmental editor comes in. The book coach is more of a rah-rah kind of person who has ideas and tactics and strategies and worksheets to help you get through the dips and things. The developmental editor works more on the content to say, hey, this story doesn't work, or you need a story here, or let's move these things around. Or, I mean, I was working with one client the other day, and his third chapter was, you need a board of directors. And I said, this isn't the third chapter. You need a chapter on coaching first. And a small company needs a board of directors. Let's put that toward the end of the book. This is not the first thing they should be thinking about.
Perfect.
And he agreed. I had another client who wrote a book about using improv in hospitals to improve communications. And she had a scenario, you know, a dialogue of a conversation gone bad between a doctor and a nurse. And then she said, if you use this improv technique, you'll improve the communications. And then she went on to another point. And I said, wouldn't it be a good idea to show an example of a good dialogue that resulted from this? Because she showed the bad dialogue. Let's show a good dialogue. And she said, oh, of course. And that would prove that her point works.
Yeah.
So those are the kinds of ways that I've helped some of my clients. Of course, I have hundreds of other stories like that. They see things you don't see because you're too close to it.
That's exactly
that's
right.
That's where developmental editor comes in.
Awesome. Love it. Well, I could speak to you forever, but our 15 minutes to move the needle in your business is coming to a close here. But I want to make sure that people have your website, and I believe you have a free gift for the audience. So let's share that.
Sure. I'm consistent in my branding. My book is called Write Your Book in a Flash. My website is Write Your Book in a Flash. And if you go to my website, you'll be able to download a chapter from my book. This is the chapter that overcomes all the limiting beliefs that are stopping you from writing your book. And believe me, I've heard all of them, from I don't have enough time to I'm not a good writer to I don't know grammar and spelling and everything else. So things that are inside your head, things that are technical, I have answers to and ideas and workbooks ideas that will help you overcome all those limiting beliefs. So just go to writeyourbookinaflash.com, download the free chapter.
Perfect.
And if you want to, buy the book as well. And if you need some help with your book, either as a ghostwriter or as a developmental editor or as a book coach, I'm happy to talk to you and see if it's a good fit.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I know my shoulders have dropped after talking to you, and I'm definitely going to implement some of your ideas. So hopefully this will get my juices flowing and I can move on to maybe chapter 3.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Awesome. Thank you again, Dan Janal. And if you guys are looking to achieve faster growth through content marketing, whether it's a podcast, social media, sales funnels, or more, look no further than smoothbusinessgrowth.com. So have a profitable and productive week, folks, and may the winds always be at your back.